How to chant with the intention to serve. Krishna is irresistibly drawn to us the moment we chant with a service attitude. In the following exercises, we will take up the essential inner attitude of seva, offering service, that inspires Krishna to appear in our hearts. He is attracted to this kind of energy because it is Srimati Radharani's mood. After he comes, he drives away material energy and cleans the mirror of our mind, washing away our anxieties, problems, and bad karma, the present and the karma which is yet to come. Srila Prabhupada also emphasized that we can chant the real holy name only when we try to serve Krishna. To illustrate this point, he invokes the well-known verse from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, which says, Atha Shri Krishna Namadi Nabhavit Krayam Indriyai Sevanmukhe Hi Jivado Svayameva Spuratyada. Therefore, material senses cannot appreciate Krishna's holy name, form, qualities, and pastimes. However, when a conditioned soul is awakened to Krishna consciousness and renders service by using his tongue to chant the Lord's holy name and tastes the remnants of the Lord's food, the tongue is purified and one gradually comes to understand who Krishna really is. Chanting in the mood of service starts with giving your attention to the holy name, as the foundational service in Kirtan and Japa is to listen to the holy name and welcome him with rapt attention. Be present-minded and not absent-minded while hearing, singing, and meditating on the holy name. Turn to Krishna while you chant. Krishna reveals himself only to his servants. He says in the Bhagavad Gita that only those can understand him who render service unto him. Once we truly begin to serve Krishna, a little match is sparked in our hearts. Then, given the right environment, it grows until the full-blown flame of our relationship with God is ablaze. The exercises which follow can dramatically help to bring the spirit of service into your chanting.